What's up, interview hackers? Sam here from ByteByByte.com, and in this video, I want to talk about how to be more strategic during your coding interviews. Because this is something that I see so much, and I see come up all the time, and I know like I used to do this myself, and it's a real big problem in coding interview prep that we're not strategic about the way that we're approaching it. Rather, we just kind of keep putting in the work, and we keep going and grinding on the same things over and over again without actually having a consistent strategy, without actually having a way that we are going to approach our coding interviews and actually plan to get better. It reminds me of practicing an instrument when I was growing up, and I didn't really like practicing instruments that much. I used to play the piano, and I would just go in and I would play the same song over and over again. And I would make mistakes. I would, you know, just kind of keep going when I made the mistakes. And what I realized over the long term was that I really didn't get better. I just kept staying at the same spot that I was. I kept grinding and grinding and grinding. I was putting in the time, but I was actually reinforcing those little mistakes, right? Because every time I would make a mistake, I wouldn't go back and correct it. And so my fingers got used to that muscle memory of screwing up every single time. And then when I went later on, when I was in college and I started studying for interviews, I realized I was doing the same thing. I was grinding problems. I used cracking the coding interview primarily to prepare for my interviews. And there were like, whatever it is, I think the previous edition was like 167 problems. And I was going through problem by problem and I would get stuck and then I would just not know what to do. So I would go to the solution. I would look at the solution. I would read the solution. I would be like, oh, that makes sense. And then I would go on. But I felt like I was never actually making progress. Right, no matter how many problems I did, no matter how many problems I completed, I was still struggling just as much as I was struggling before. Every new problem was completely new. There was no strategy behind it, and there was no way of going from, you know, studying one problem to that one actually helping me get better at solving problems in the future. And so what I realized is that I had to start being strategic, and the concept that I want to share with you today is this idea of going from what to how. This is one of the simplest ways that we can move to being more strategic in anything that we're doing, that we can move to being more strategic in our interviewing, that we can move to being more strategic in any goal that we want to accomplish. We go from asking what to asking how. And I want you to think about this in terms of coding interviews. So think about when you go and you practice problems. What do we normally do? We ask what questions. We ask, what is the answer to this question? If you get stuck, you don't say, you just go and look at the solution and you're like, what is the answer to this problem? You look at it, you read it, and you're like, okay, now I know the answer to the problem. But the problem with this is that it doesn't actually help you get better. And so what you need to switch to doing is asking how. How would I solve this problem? How did this other person get from seeing that problem definition to the solution that they came up with? Because obviously someone saw the problem and figured out what the solution was. And it doesn't actually matter what the solution is because the solution is different to every single problem, right? You can look at solution after solution after solution. And eventually, yes, you get used to the patterns. You get used to seeing the same things come up over and over again. But it doesn't actually help you get better other than in the sense of like you're essentially memorizing problems. But if you shift your mindset from asking what the solution is to asking how, it totally changes everything. You can also think about this in terms of even like what you're choosing to study. Instead of asking, what should I study? Ask, how should I study? How do I actually go from where I am now to where I want to be? How do I do this thing? How do I figure out the solution? Because a big part of understanding these problems and a big part of getting better at your interview prep and getting better at coding interviews is understanding the thought process behind it, being able to create that process for yourself. So I would highly encourage you to think about how do I shift from asking these what questions to asking these how questions? How could I shift from asking someone to do the work for me to doing the work myself? Because that's the other thing that happens when you ask that how question is it's no longer asking someone to do the work for you. When you ask what, you're basically asking someone to tell you the answer. You're asking someone to give you like what is the solution. It's like cheating on a test. You may get a good grade. You may get the solution because someone told you the solution or you like looked at the solution on someone's paper, but it doesn't actually make you better at doing the thing yourself. And so you just become reliant on this like cheating. You become reliant on this getting the answer from somewhere else and you never learn how to do it yourself. And so that's all I have for you today. I want you to think about how you can switch from asking that what question to asking that how question in your interview prep, and how you can use that to guide you towards getting the right solution, towards understanding the underlying approach to how to solve these problems. And with that, that's all I got for you. If you enjoyed this video, definitely go over to, let me pull this up for you, bytebybyte.com/50questions and check out my free 50 coding interview questions guide where you'll get solutions. I'll actually show you the how. Not the why, but the how of how to solve 50 of the most common coding interview questions. We've already had thousands and thousands of people download it, and I think you'll find it super, super useful. I appreciate you joining me here today, and I look forward to seeing you in the next video.